Hi, everybody. Reese Davis with you, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites.
Joe I.A. Stadium here in Ruston, Louisiana, on the campus of Louisiana Tech, a stadium that opened back in 1968. Seating's made of two large bowed grandstands on either side of the field, built into a natural bowl. The pregame festivities are over, and we're just about set to get this game underway. Bryant fields it at the two. He's taken down at the 29. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it.
Like that they're completing these underneath routes, because pretty soon the defense is going to start to cheat up. That's when the quarterback will have his chance to go over the top for the big play.
Second and three. Ball on their own 36. Here's the halfback. And he shoved out of bounds at about the 43-yard line. He'll pick up a first down with that run from the halfback.
Well, that's a strong run. It makes a statement when you can run the ball like that.
By 56, by 56.
Very good tackle in space.
That's a deep run on the play. Let's go. That brings up second and one.
From the 48-yard line, it's second down.
By 56, by 56.
He makes a catch and has a first down. 4-yard gain, and that'll be a first down.
I think they were expecting a run on that play, Brad, and it allowed the quarterback to throw for just enough yards to get the first down.
And I think it was the quick throw by the quarterback that fouled up the defense on that one. And oh, he dropped it.
The defense always likes to see a pass broken up, but getting the turnover would have been really big.
Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 44-yard line. And he carries the ball for a nice game. Scooped up. He's taken down at the 46-yard line.
Close one there. Maybe the ball carrier will try a little harder to secure the ball next time.
Thomas looking to knock one inside the 20 here on this punt. Gets out to about the 21. The Bulldogs and their coaching staff, Kirk, just happy to have a guy like this in the program. Their offense really clicks when he's playing well.
Well, I think it gives them the diversity that they're looking for. I mean, at times they're going to run the football. Other times they're going to try to air it out. And when you have one guy that gets so much attention on the outside, it just seems to open up other aspects of their offensive attack. And they've done a good job as an offensive staff of putting together a good plan. And I'm sure we're going to see it again today.
From their own 21-yard line, second down. Nearly intercepted.
Garcia breaks it up. Third down.
Fourth down, I'm coming as they go three and out.
You always like to move the ball at least past midfield. if only to win the field position battle. The defense wasn't going to give them anything on that drive.
The defense has everybody on the line. I think they're going to come after this one. And he's taken down at the 42-yard line. They've got to play with some focus and smarts here. They don't want to make a mistake and suddenly find themselves trailing. From the 42-yard line, second down. Tackle at the 30.
That was a really nice play on the ball by the receiver for a substantial gain and a first down.
That makes it first and 10.
Run up the middle.
That'll bring up second and three.
They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. And he's going to come up with a sack.
To me, that's on the quarterback. He's got to be able to recognize and use his eyes and vision to be able to see that the corner is coming on a blitz. The offense didn't do a good job of picking up the blitz, but the quarterback's got to be able to see that and make the throw quickly to get the ball before the corner can sack him.
Third down, and they need to get it down to the 20. And he might want it all here, and does! Can't haul it in. That'll bring up fourth and long, and we should be seeing the kicker here.
Good stand by the defense to keep them out of the end zone on this drive.
Stepping up, sacked, and they'll turn it over. Defense stiffens on fourth down, and the ball will change hands. I don't think either team has a clear advantage so far. Let's see if they can make some plays and get a little separation. Nice run to the left there.
That's a good system. That brings him second and five.
We've got a second and five. Ball on their own 40. A quarterback in the gun with five receivers. He's out of bounds at the 44-yard line.
That'll make it third and one.
They'll line up with five wide receivers. Now he pitches it at the corner. He goes out of bounds at the 49-yard line. So the halfback gets the first down there with a 5-yard carry.
That's one of the worst feelings for a defender. You've got the guy in your grasp, and you let him get away. That's the kind of play that coaches grind their teeth over.
He makes it out to midfield. We've played one. No score here. And we're back for more action here in quarter number two. Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. About 6 yards on the play.
You get 6 yards, and that makes picking up a first down very reasonable.
It's third down, and they're about 2 yards shy of the sticks. tight end. They'll bring him down at the 31-yard line. Receiver, and that one probably should have been picked off.
Yeah, are you kidding me? There's a blanket around that receiver. Somebody else had to be open.
So it's second and 10. Ball on the 31-yard line. They'll spread the field here. Let's see what the defense does with a five wide outlook. Tackle made right around the 20. This is the ninth play of the current drive. Inside the 10. He's tackled
at about the 7-yard line.
First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. Steps up. Here's a throw, and it's almost picked.
You like a team that's ready to defend the pass. It takes some preparation to get in the way of a pass like that.
And this is the 11th play of the current drive. Fires in there, got it, touchdown. Call it a catch, but the booth signaled down to the referee that they'd like to take another peek at this.
Man, as I see this play again, it really looks like he made the correct call on the field.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field stands.
So after some discussion, the call on the field stands. Louisiana Tech is up by 6. He makes the PAT. An 11-play, 66-yard drive, and they get it in for 7. They line up to kick this one away. He's to the 20. Across the 30. Tackle at the 34-yard line. There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. He's at midfield. Makes it out to about the 46.
Nothing tentative on that run at all. He looked very determined and got the first down.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 46. Quick throw, and they make the stop at the 45.
That brings up second and 9.
Two times. White 56. Go 4. Orange 3. Orange 3.
He gets rid of this one. Down now, and they need to get it down to the 36. Fires it out, and he's tackled around the 43-yard line. Couple of yards there.
The offense is trying to get the ball into the hands of the halfback here, and he did a pretty good job of getting a few yards, but the defense was just swarming to the ball right there.
He'll try to knock this punt down inside the 20. It's away. Short punt. Momentum swings have been fairly even, And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Louisiana Tech is up by a touchdown. Runs it right and can't get away. Nice tackle. Maybe a yard on the run by the tailback.
That'll bring up second and 11.
From their own 24-yard line, second down. Runs it and tackle in the backfield.
That's a loss of 4 yards on the play. That makes it third and 15.
Wildcats taking their first time out of the half. So they end up with a loss after calling the draw.
He started out rushing the passer and then just got lucky and ran right into the running back on the draw.
Brought down at about the 23-yard line. And that was a nice stretch for the D there.
Yeah, they really cranked it up a notch on that series.
Drew to punt. He drops it. Looking for the corner. He makes it to the 35-yard line. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions.
5-56, 5-56. Set, loop 14, loop 14.
There's a strike complete. He gets hit out of bounds. At the 25. Nice pickup as they connect on the pass play.
Well, they look to be in sync right now. They're both reading the defense properly, and the result is a nice game.
It's second down, and they're about the length of the football from the first down marker. Complete. He's got room. And down he goes at the 21. It's complete for about 4 yards and a first down.
It took some composure on the quarterback's part here to stand in there and make the throw with the blitz coming in. Well done.
Green 15.
Makes the catch and look out. And he's pushed out of bounds, setting up a first and goal.
Gain of 13 on the play. That makes it first and goal.
It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here.
Three down, three down. Mike 56, Mike 56. Red, two.
Throws a bullet over the middle, and he's taken down right around the 2 yard line.
At the 2 yard line. That brings up second and goal.
Touchdown, Wildcats.
There are some guys, when they get near the goal line, they just have a knack for getting the ball into the end zone. That's what we saw right there.
Here's the PAT to tie this thing up. And he converts the extra point. Let's check in with Reese Davis in the studio.
The Volunteer Navy has arrived. Tennessee set to run through the tee in Knoxville.
The Hokies deliver the perfect connection and a touchdown.
And for Mackey, they can't cover it. More than 150 yards receiving. Tennessee leads it 14-7.
I don't expect that that score is going to hold, but boy, that would be an upset. Thomas has the ball set, and he looks ready to kick this one deep. He's to the 20. Tackle made at the 23-yard line. Both defenses really played well so far.
Well, up to this point, both defenses have dominated this football game. We'll see if they can hold on to that mentality the rest of the way.
You always want to go in the locker room with momentum, so as we get closer to halftime, I think we'll see more and more attempts to create big plays. Straight in the middle, and he meets the defense. Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 24-yard line.
Hey, check right, check right. Five.
Hey, guns it. Third and 10 coming up. Ball on their own 24. Going deep, lays it out there. And he's got it, going the other way now. He's taken down at the 50-yard line. And just a great interception by the cornerback.
Boy, that's big time. He made a great read on the quarterback and got in there for the pick.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 50. Going for it all to the end zone. Oh, he had a shot at the pick. Hit and taken down.
I think it was a great play call, and it was very well executed. Any coach would be happy with that kind of outcome on a first or second down play.
So it's third down, and they've got about 2 yards to go. Let's see if a quarterback heaves it up there, and one of his guys can come down with it. He chucks it downfield. The defender had it and then dropped it. We've played a half. We get a tie game at 7-7.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollock here completely locked in on that first half. The stats are certainly not overwhelming from an offensive standpoint. These two teams averaging less than 6 yards per pass attempt. That's not really what you're after in the passing game. But a lot of it can be attributed to really good defense. You know quarterbacks want to take care of the ball first, but they also want to push it down the field. How do you balance that with this guy? Not a lot of room downfield to throw the ball, it doesn't seem, but he's taking the check down pretty quick.
Yeah, well, and if there is no room down the field, and you don't see very many open receivers just streaking. I mean, you haven't seen that. So the defense is doing a good job of taking that deep stuff away. But the number one thing is, if you're going to bail out Reese and you give him that underneath stuff, that easy pass completion, you got to tackle. And that's what they're doing. They're coming up and they're not letting him, you know, throw a 7-yard route that goes 50 yards. And that's one of the biggest keys to defense. Let him throw the underneath stuff, come up, make a good tackle, live to fight another down.
You know, I had a wise coach once tell me, teams do not beat you throwing and catching. They beat you by running after the catch.
David and I will be keeping an eye on your game and everything else going on in the country here in our palatial and comfortable surroundings in the studio. The best seat in the house belongs to Brad Nessler in Kirk Herb Street.
Welcome back to the action. Second half just about set to begin. We got a tight game here. He sends this one deep. He's to the 20. And he's tackled at the 28. Now's when you start to approach each drive thinking that if you take the lead, then the momentum you gain feels that much more powerful. From their own 28-yard line. Second down. He rifles it. This one will fall incomplete. Wants it all. Going deep. Almost picked off.
Anderson breaks us up. Fourth down.
Bryant back to return it. Brought down at the 46-yard line. And he gets just a little on the return.
That time the coverage was all over.
Time's getting a little bit tighter now. You got to make every possession count. Second and 10. Ball on their own 46. The Wildcats wide receiver down there on the sideline. Looks like he's warming up. Good to see that he might be able to get back in this game. Stays in bounds to make a nice catch. Good pitch and catch there on second down.
Yep, it was good enough to get him a first down. That's just a nice play.
Gets out to about the 38-yard line.
That makes it second and six.
From the 38-yard line, it's second down. He gets out to about the 21-yard line.
Super effort by the tailback to pick up a nice gain and a first down. He's really a good-looking ball carrier.
Huge play, and now they're in a great position to score.
Gain of 16 yards. That makes it first and goal.
First and goal from the 5. They're knocking on the door. Steps out of bounds at the 1.
That brings up second and goal.
This defense not wanting to give an inch here. Touchdown, Kansas State. So they punch it in on the ground, Kirk Herbstreit.
Great job up front by the offensive line. They get a good, strong push that allowed the runner to get it in there for the touchdown.
And he adds the extra point. Kansas State is lining up to kick this one off. Seal takes it from the 6. And he just got drilled. Kansas State's the type of team, when you look at them, it looks like their defense sort of just feeds off it.
I think the energy is there, Brad, but I think it really starts up front with their defensive line and their linebackers. The way they're being able to just win the battle at the line of scrimmage, I think it's giving them confidence, and it's allowing them to play more downhill where they can attack this offense.
In the shotgun and 5 wideouts.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
Tries to fit it in there, and it'll be intercepted. They'll bring him down at the 8-yard line. By 7 and looking at first and goal. Kansas State up 7 points. He's tackled at about the 9-yard line.
If these defenders continue to exploit the O-line like that, it's going to be a long day for this running back.
From the 13-yard line, it's third down. the 7-yard line. Kansas State can make this a two-possession game with this field goal. The kick is up, and the field goal is good. Let's throw it out to Reese now for a studio update.
The Fighting Irish took the field ranked number 8, and knowing with the pressure behind them, they had to perform to hold that spot. And for Notre Dame, here's a team trying to win the first game of the year. The Fighting Irish have the edge, 21-20.
10-point game here, Reese, 17-7. Thomas looks ready to kick this one off. He'll return it from the 3. He gets out to about the 25-yard line. You know the offense will be looking to do better this time out.
Anytime you give the ball away, it's a disappointment. So these guys want to show that they can hang on to it.
Packer at about the 37-yard line. From their own 37-yard line, it's first down. Caught, and he's hit immediately.
That'll make it second and 7.
And they get nice yardage on that run.
That's how we do, D.
It's third down, and they're about 2 yards shy of the sticks. Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. And he's tackled around the 44-yard line. Space.
This isn't even the best example, but I'm going to tell you something. This young man is really getting better at running his routes, which is a truly underrated quality these days.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 28-yard line. Caught, open field, and they make the stop around the 23-yard line.
Gain of 5 yards. That brings him second and 5.
Now he's scrambling. Ball is loose, fumble. It's scooped up. Exactly what this defense was looking for.
Yeah, that fumble gives these guys some added life. Now let's see if they can capitalize off of it.
So now both teams come trotting back out onto the field. Up the middle for a nice game. A quarter to go, and can they pull the upset? The Wildcats with a 10-point lead. All right, we're just about set to start action here again in the fourth quarter. Yardage.
Gain of 6 yards. First down.
First and 10. Ball on the 44-yard line.
Mike 56. Back five.
gets to about the 44-yard line.
Picked up a yard of anything on that run.
Boy, the senior linebacker's experience really showed on that run. He sniffed it out perfectly and made the tackle.
That's good for a gain of 13 yards. First down. First and 10. Ball on the 43.
Mike 56.
Makes it out to about the 33.
That's a gain of 10 on the play. That'll make it second and inches.
Down he goes at the 33.
No gain. That makes it first and 10.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 33.
Mike 56.
Quick throw, and he's immediately tackled.
First down.
And this is the eighth play of the drive.
Four down. Mike 56.
Brought down at about the 15-yard line.
That makes it second and 10.
Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 15. It's third down, and this offense is about 3 feet away from that first down marker. Less than 3 minutes in the game.
Brad, you just don't see this very often anymore in college football. That is their fifth first down on this drive alone. They have great rhythm right now as an offense, and look at that poor defense. They're looking over to the sidelines to the defensive coordinator for some help. They need to change things up.
And they got to him before he could get back to the line.
I'm not even sure the ball carrier saw the corner coming for him. That happened so fast, he never had a chance to make a move.
Here's the 12th play of the drive.
When you're that close to the end zone, it's always a smart play to find your blockers and follow them into the end zone.
And he tacks on the extra point. Let's get an update now. Here's Reese Davis. Reese.
The Hokies enter today ranked fourth. That is now in the past tense. How far will they fall? An old coach once said, if you don't think every game's important, just try losing one. Apparently, this team believed it. They tried, and they lost. A major upset is now in the books. And for Jenkins, he went for more than 100 yards in this one. The Volunteers top it off with a 7-point win. Elsewhere, the Seminoles were ranked number 6. They hope that performance will move them up in the polls. And for FSU, they've won 2 straight. Florida State comes away with a 9-point victory.
Thanks, Reese. 24-7 in our game here. They line up to kick this one away. He gets out to about the 32-yard line. offense couldn't hang on to the ball last time around. Let's see what happens here.
The first rule on offense is to take care of the football. These guys need to remember that on this drive.
Quick strike and he drops it.
Seals was the intended receiver on the play. That makes it second and 10.
Second down, 10 yards to go.
Ball on the 32.
Just under 2 minutes in the game. Zips it to the tailback, incomplete.
There's one the quarterback would like to rewind because he has a wide open receiver and he just misfires.
There are five wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun. Fires out to his receiver. He's taken down at the 42-yard line. Pressure coming, and now the ball is loose. The offense falls on it.
It's a good job of securing the fumble and avoiding a turnover.
Spikes the ball. Well, they've converted one third down play on this drive, but now they're faced with a third and long. Pass out to the tight end, but it's incomplete.
Harris was the intended receiver on the play. Fourth down.
Everybody up close. It looks like they're coming after this kick. Oh, man, did he take a hit. The Wildcats refused to believe the hype and that they were going to be the team getting blown out. Here they are doing the damage.
Well, you and I talked to some of their players on Friday at the walkthrough. They kind of had a look in their eye, in fact, even brought up to us. They're tired of hearing about how they don't have much of a chance. They've sure demonstrated their attitude out there today. What a big win and major upset.
Tackled after a decent pickup.
That makes it second and six.
From their own 45-yard line, second down. Under a minute left in the game. Gain as he works the right side.
That'll bring up third and inches.
Double tight, double tight. Four down, four down. Mike 56, 56.
The Bulldogs, I'm sure, are secure in the knowledge that despite this setback today, they still have one of the best players in the country.
Well, this is a devastating loss, but it's one that they're going to have to put behind them. And as you said, they still have one of the best players in the country. They don't need to deviate their plan. Get back to really what they know, and that's getting the ball to their star player. And next week, I'm sure they'll be fine.
That's going to do it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying goodbye.